Hello sir, good morning. Welcome to the show. And I don't want to waste your precious time, so let's start straight away. Sir, recently I have seen many releases of yours in print media regarding total knee replacement. And what is the scope of total knee replacement in this knee pain treatment?
Yes, total knee replacement has been, we are doing a lot of total knee replacements earlier of late. We find that trend to be increasing. Day by day, we are doing more and more numbers. And this is because we find a lot of youngsters, even as young as 30 to 40 years of age, coming with knee pain. So I'll give you an overview of total knee replacement. TKR, that's what we call it in short. TKR is done for people who have knee pain. And knee pain is caused by osteoarthritis, teimanam. Or degenerative arthritis. It's a degenerative condition, usually found in elderly people 60 years and above, but sometimes we even find it as young as 30 or 40 years of age. And usually such patients, they go to a number of different modalities of treatment. They try out Ayurvedic treatment, they try out homeopathic treatment, they try out allopathic treatment, Western medicine. They try out physical therapy. They try out a lot of different modalities of physical therapy, heat therapy, current therapy, wax therapy and so on, exercises. And if none of these modalities work in giving them significant pain relief, that is when we opt for total knee replacement. That is for the end stage of osteoarthritis, or as we call it, the stage 4 osteoarthritis, advanced osteoarthritis. That is when we opt for total knee replacement. That is, the patient has to come, the person has to come and demand for a total knee replacement. He has to have such an unbearable pain that his day-to-day activities are hampered by that pain. And he has difficulty in as much as walking a few feet for his daily activities. So that is when, that is the scope, or that is the indication for a total knee replacement.
So these patients will be, like you mentioned, mostly will be of, majority will be 60 plus. And at that time, it is possible that these people will be having some kind of diseases, like say for example, diabetes, hypertensive, sometimes a heart disease or something. And is surgery possible on those type of people?
Very true. As you said, a total knee replacement is generally done for people who are elderly, more than 60-65 years of age. Though we do find some trend where we find exceptional cases where even youngsters as young as 19 we have done a joint replacement for. Unfortunately, elderly people usually come with other comorbidities. They often have either diabetes, they have hypertension, high blood pressure, or they might have cardiac disease, kidney failure, and a number of other possible conditions. Fortunately, advancements in TKR, that is total knee replacement techniques, have ensured that even such patients can be operated with a minimal risk possible. We have advancements in TKR techniques such as minimally invasive techniques, which we use routinely to minimize the blood loss as well as shorten the surgical duration. We have computer navigation these days, which ensures our precision while doing surgery is phenomenally perfect. And even anesthesia techniques have improved considerably, so that even cardiac patients and patients with renal failure, it is possible to do a risk-free, I wouldn't say completely risk-free, but nearly risk-free total knee replacement possible. And coming to cardiac disease, we recently, I remember, had a patient by name Mr. Rajagopal. He was again an elderly gentleman, and he has been suffering with both knees pain, severe knee pain since the last decade or so. And once he came with me, his main problem was he had an ischemic heart disease. He had a heart disease, and several hospitals had refused to perform surgery for this gentleman because of the high risk involved. However, since we are using the latest techniques such as the computer navigation and minimally invasive techniques, we chose to perform, we opted to perform the replacement, and we did bilateral, that is both knees in a single day for this gentleman. For the cardiac part of it, we took the fitness from a cardiologist who had said we can proceed, who had consented for the same, and again anesthesiologist gave the fitness for surgery. And with minimal risk, this gentleman underwent surgery, and he was up and walking within the third post-operative day. And within 1 week, he was able to climb stairs, he was able to get onto the bed, get out of the bed, bend his knees considerably, and he was almost nearly pain-free.
So this same sort of replacement can be done for hip also, I believe. Could you please elaborate on total hip replacement?
Yes, Akhil. Like total knee replacement, there is something called total hip replacement. And similar to the knee joint, even the hip joint can get affected with arthritis. There are a number of conditions which lead to degeneration of the hip joint. There is something called as avascular necrosis of femur. There is a condition called Perthes disease in the childhood. And such diseases may even affect youngsters as young as 15 or 16. Recently, we performed a total hip replacement last week for a boy who was hardly 19, and his name, I recall, was Gurumurthy. He has been suffering with hip pain since the last 4-5 years and has gone to a number of places to get it checked up, and everybody came to a conclusion that a total hip replacement had to be done for this young boy. And for cost effectiveness, because of other cost considerations, he has been postponing the surgery and living with this constant pain. And fortunately, we were able to do it economically, and within a week this boy was up and running, I would say. And now he is comfortable, he is happy after a total hip replacement was done for him. This boy had a shortening. His one leg was shorter than the other leg by nearly 5 to 6 centimeters, which was corrected during the hip replacement surgery.
Sir, apart from this replacement surgery, what all complicated surgery you perform in Ahalya?
Apart from joint replacements, we do a number of other procedures. We fix fractures, we do trauma surgeries. We deal with pediatric deformities. We have done a number of children who have had bent legs, bowed legs, club foot, which have all been corrected here. And we do spine surgeries in particular. In fact, we are upcoming as the foremost center for spinal surgeries in Palakkad region. Coming to spine, specifically, we do discectomies, we do minimally invasive discectomies, and we do posterior instrumentation and fusion and deformity corrections occasionally. That reminds me, of late we have had a number of interesting patients with spinal problems. We had one gentleman coming all the way from Madurai, Rajapalayam. His name was Sangli Kalai. He was an elderly gentleman who had severe back pain since the last several years. And one of his legs had become weaker, and he had a lot of difficulty walking, was limping all the time, and he could barely walk beyond 10 feet at a stretch. He had a huge disc on the MRI pressing on the nerve root, and the only thing that could relieve him of pain was a surgery. He had already tried Ayurveda, he had tried a number of other modalities, and still his pain was not relieved. And finally, one fine day, we operated on him and we did a fenestration and a minimally invasive surgery, wherein within using just a 2 centimeter of surgical incision, we opened up his spine and we removed the pathological disc. And immediately after the disc was removed, this patient was very comfortably walking the very next day after surgery. His limp had completely vanished and he had no pain whatsoever. It is said that removing a disc is like removing a foreign body which has fallen to the eye. That is the amount of irritation a disc causes, and that is the amount of relief you get once the disc is removed.
One final question, sir. Is knee replacement possible for a person with a deformity? Suppose he has a bent knees and he is having this knee pain too. And is knee replacement possible on that kind of patients?
We do find that knee arthritis causes deformities. And in several instances, there are patients who have basically neglected the knee pain for many, many years, or sometimes even decades, who come with highly deformed knees. And it is possible to surgically correct the deformities and give them near normal and straight knees and painless knees by total knee replacement. Often it is very challenging and laborious, but it is very much possible. With the right techniques in the right center, such deformities can and have been corrected. We have a number of such successful instances. We had a patient by name Mr. Srinivas recently, who had very deformed knees. His knees were bent by 55 to 60 degrees to start with, and he was limping badly, and his limp and his pain was incapacitating him. He was hardly able to go out of his house. His confidence had been shaken completely, and he was stooping and walking. He was completely handicapped, to say the least. And we did operate on him, and surgically his knees were corrected. And the day he got operated, I remember the moment he came out of anesthesia and he saw his knees for the first time, this gentleman cried. He was so happy, and the result was so gratifying. And within 3 days, he was walking comfortably, painlessly, and with straight knees, with the strides of a very confident man now.
Thanks a lot, sir. And this session was very informative. And thanks a lot. Once again, thanks a lot for your time.